Hi guys, welcome back to the Acme channel. It's your girl Liz, aka Pretty Purpose 23. Today's video is all about hair and its connection with acne. And I think the first thing when people think of when it comes to treating your skin is like skincare products, you know, how you cleanse, what active treatments do you use, and they don't really think about the correlation between hair and your skin. And there's actually a strong connection, and hair is one of the main things that actually worsen your acne. So I'm gonna get into some of the life-saving hair hack tips that help you improve your skin. So let's get right into it. Number one is wearing bangs or even just having some sort of fringe. So I used to have a side fringe. I used to have bangs. And I still have like a mini kind of fringe that goes out like this. These are some of the photos of my hairstyles. And your hair produces these natural oils. It touches your scalp, it touches your face, and it mixes with your own facial oils, dead skin cells, and it clogs up your pores. So if you're wearing bangs and you find that you're having like a lot of acne pimples around your forehead, around your hairline, it's definitely attributed to your hair oils. And you want to avoid that by clipping it up for the time being. When I had acne around my forehead, I covered it with my bangs, and it was a vicious cycle. I didn't want to wear my hair any other way because I didn't want people to see my pimples. The more I hid it, the worse it got. So definitely try to wear your fringe like in different ways, clipping it up, braiding it like this, doing different looks. And trust me, when I got rid of my fringe, my skin definitely improved. Number two, using a two-in-one shampoo. Often it sounds super convenient, but when it comes to two-in-one shampoos or like just hair products, where it's a combination of, you know, shampoo and conditioner, or if it's like shampoo for your face and for your body, for everything, it's often very stripping and very heavy for your skin to handle and clog your pores. So be very careful with those kind of two-in-one products. Number three is using like hair products and spraying on your hair, whether it be dry shampoo, gel, or hairspray, or like moisturizing lotions for your hair, and it sits on your face as well. So these products actually further irritate your skin because they're not for your skin. Your skin is a lot more sensitive than your hair, and all the product again is just layering that oils and dead skin cells, further clogging up your pores. So I have literally stopped wearing hair products. Like, it does not help my skin, especially when I used to have long hair and I had hair products here, my chest would break out, my back would break out, and so I just don't like to wear hair products. If you are wearing hair products, make sure that you have some sort of like, I don't know, like a shield here to spray your hair, or use your hand, whatever it is, to help prevent it from touching your skin. Four, shampooing at the wrong time. Now this is a little bit crazy. Like, I never even thought about this, but when you shower and you wash your hair, it's actually best to wash it like at night. If you wash your hair in the morning, throughout the day, your hair is gonna get oily. The oils are gonna accumulate onto your skin and again, breakouts. So I highly recommend showering like just before bed or like a few hours before bed so your hair can dry and you're sleeping on clean hair, because you don't want the hair to go all over your face, all over your pillow, and the oils accumulate, etc. So best to shower at night. Showering way too often in terms of washing your hair. Like, you can shower every single day, but wear like a shower cap. This is something that I've struggled with for the longest time. I trained my hair, well, I didn't train it. I pretty much forced it into a really bad habit where I washed it every single day. And so the next day, within a couple of hours, my hair starts to get really, really oily and I hate it, so I wash it again. And then I wash it again. And so some people go with like 3 days to 4 days without washing their hair, and I'm just like, wow, that's absolutely amazing. And their hair doesn't even get oily. So you need to go through that training process where you're not washing it every single day. And I think the first couple of months is gonna be tough. I'm still battling with that. So that's something that I need to work on. So definitely try to see if you can do this as well. If, for example, I know that my hair is super, super oily, I wear like a head cap when I go to bed. So then it's not like going everywhere, it's not on my face. That really, really helps. And the last mistake that a lot of people do is actually just leaving their hair out. So sometimes when you have acne, it's hard and it really sucks, but tying up your hair really makes a difference. And sometimes you want your hair to be out and flowy, or sometimes you want it to be hiding your skin, but it's actually not doing you any good. So make sure you're tying it up. I think that's pretty much it for today. Like, I mean, one of the obvious is like, you know, wearing hats or like head accessories. Hats kind of accumulate the humidity and the sweat again going onto your skin and your face, causing greater breakouts. So those are the main tips that you have to avoid. But in summary, hair does have a lot to do with your skin. If I've missed anything out, definitely comment down below. I'll do another video when it comes to hair products because I'm still learning bits and pieces about that, and hopefully I can give you some recommendations. Other than that, these are just practical tips to help you. In the meantime, I hope you guys have a lovely day, and big kisses. Mwah. Bye guys.